stand on a stage at a bluegrass festival in Virginia and I sing in Chinese, you know. It's like I look out and all these guys in these lawn chairs are like, what's she doing? You know, and like afterwards they're like, they come up to me and everybody has got a story about China. Everybody, you know, my aunt's sister adopted a daughter, my blah, blah, blah. I mean, everybody's got a connection to China and it brings it out when you share it through music. I'm Abigail Washburn and I play the banjo and I sing in both English and Chinese, and I care a lot about the future of how U.S. and China get along. It started out that I just got really obsessed with Chinese culture in college, and I ended up majoring in it. And after school, I went on to study the Hanyu Shui Ping Kao Shi, or the Chinese equivalency exam, and I wanted to go to law school in Beijing. So that was my plan. And one night I was at a party, and I heard the sound of Doc Watson singing and playing Shady Grove. And I just thought it was so beautiful. And after years of studying Chinese culture, it was like this profound relief to hear something so truly American, so truly awesome. So I bought a banjo, and it was soul-filling in a way that that other work wasn't. And luckily, I've learned that music is an incredibly powerful way to connect the two cultures, rather than doing what I thought I originally was going to do, which was this like attempt at some kind of top-down policy change or judicial system reform. I ended up being a person who just travels the world playing the banjo and singing, and I've at least felt that connection in a very profound way, that connection between hearts. If culture, the beauty of our two cultures, was a larger part of the connection between these two nations, it would have a profound impact on how we hear each other and how we envision our future together.